All right, so here comes certificate of origin. So certificate of origin, as we discussed, this is unique in the NAFTA because you must have it before, at the time of making a NAFTA claim. So pretty much you can safely say you must have it before you have you can make the NAFTA claim. It comes on CBP form, and this is a requirement, 434. And it's an absolute must. This is what that certificate of origin looks like. I again pulled it off the CBP website, and you fill in those fields, and if you don't have this filled out, so you have some requirements for this field, although this is, if I may say, bare bones requirement. There is much more to this than just that. You even have the Customs and Border Protection Directive, the Directive 3810. It hasn't been required on the customs broker exam, but it gives you various paragraphs, and it clarifies how and what must be done to get a NAFTA claim. So going back to the outline, so the general rule, and again, this is general rule because we know that by now we should know that you have a rule and you have lots of exceptions, and sometimes exceptions eat the rule. Here, this is not likely the case. Exceptions do not eat the rule because a lot of these exceptions are narrowly construed. So let's take a look at the rule. Importer must be in possession of NAFTA certificate of origin before or at the time. The preferential duty claim for North American Free Trade Agreement is made. All right, so let's take a look at the exam question, how it is being tested. So which of the following allows the broker to claim a trade preference treatment for NAFTA? So this is a callable question. And briefly scanning through the answer choices, we can kind of get a sense of what is to come. So okay, let's take a look at the fact pattern. A client has requested that a customs broker, act as his agent in the clearance of goods that he recently purchased in Canada. So Canada is a NAFTA country, so far so good, with intent of importing the goods into the United States. Because the goods were purchased in Canada, the client would like the broker to claim NAFTA. Which of the following will allow the licensed customs broker to file a claim on behalf of his client? So the goods were purchased in Canada. All right, so the mere fact that they were purchased does not make it a NAFTA eligible product. What if you have a case of transshipment? What if you have a product which was purchased in China, imported into Canada, nothing was done there, and then it is being exported from Canada to the United States? Does it make that Chinese good a Canadian product? No. So that is not likely to survive the scrutiny. Since we are looking for NAFTA preferential elements, this is not it. A is incorrect. The client requested tariff preference treatment under NAFTA. Well, the client request by itself is not sufficient. It must be substantiated. Remember that CBP form 434 is the required part. Of course, it must be done by who? By the client? Well, if the client is an exporter, that's fine. But if the client is a producer, not the exporter, that may not be enough. It must be done by the exporter. So that's B is incorrect. The broker is familiar with the supplier, and the supplier of goods have qualified for tariff preference treatment under NAFTA in the past. Well, remember that directive, the 3810 directive that we discussed. Here is a paragraph about the suppliers or producers, right? So it clearly says the certificate must be signed by the exporter or by the exporter's authorized agent having knowledge of relevant facts. Producers who are not, and usually knowledge of relevant fact means you have a paper trail, you have a documentation trail to prove that it is in fact going under NAFTA. Producers who are not exporters may choose to prepare a certificate and provide it to the exporter. So here is that paper trail that I was talking about. But there is no requirement that they do so. And here is come the punchline. In no case, this will relieve the exporters of their obligation to prepare the certificate of origin. We can add one form, on CBP form 434. So this means for us that the mere familiarity is not enough. D. The client informed the broker that he has a complete and properly executed copy of a certificate of origin in his possession covering the imported goods. So this is marked as the correct answer. I would go beyond that. Yes, the importer must be in possession before preferential duty is made, but as a part of the due diligence, it would be meaningful to say the client not only informed the broker, but also provided the copy of that CBP form 434 for in order to make the claim. Because the client may have given a call and made that statement, but when the audit comes in, the client may back out and say, hey, wait a minute, he knows the stuff, this is why I hired him, he's a professional. He should have asked me before. Because usually the clients, the importers especially, who watch for their bottom line and who are effectively directed by preferential duty treatment, they are likely to have to be influenced by the passions of the moment, if you will, not by the by the legal criteria. So the licensed customs broker really must watch for undue pressure and must also have a paper trail of his own. So I would say this is correct in the customs broker exam, but customs CBP examiner should have said and provide to, because that would be a better answer. The goods were manufactured in Canada. Well, listen, the mere manufacture in Canada may not qualify it under the preferential duty treatment under the NAFTA, because you also have to have certain things. It doesn't say it was wholly made and produced. Remember that buzzwords, wholly made and produced, when we look at the general notes and looking at the qualifying criteria for a trade agreement, whichever trade agreement it may be. Well, let's say it was manufactured in Canada, but it did not make the tariff shift. Remember, we talked about tariff shifting. If it did not make a tariff shift, it doesn't make trade agreement, the NAFTA. It doesn't qualify. Or let's say it made a tariff shift, but there was an exception to the rule. Remember that elastomeric yarn exception, where even mere presence of elastomeric yarn may disqualify even if it's tiny minuscule one, like de minimis one, it still may disqualify certain apparel or textiles from a particular free trade agreement. The case point was in Morocco when we discovered, even though we saw exception to an exception, you really have to look at the details. So that general statement that manufacturing Canada may or may not, so this is just not enough information, but copy of the certificate of origin is straight to the point. So D is correct answer choice for this particular question.